डिस्कसिंग ग्रुप डिस्कशन. ग्रुप डिस्कशन इज द फर्स्ट टॉपिक ऑफ द फर्स्ट टास्क ऑफ द जीटीओ जीटीओ एंड इट इज इनडोर. बिफोर जीटीओ मेक्स अ ग्रुप और बैच, यू हैड नॉट नोन ईच अदर वेल प्रायर टू दैट. एंड द फर्स्ट टाइम यू स्टार्टेड कॉलिंग योर सेल्फ by chest numbers 1 to 10. You want to find out from where did you come and all sorts of interaction started, but still you do not know what is the caliber of each other, because you have to compete with each other to find out who is at what level. Are you better than them or you are not so good as they are? If you are better, you feel confident. If you are not so good, probably you like to raise your level so that you can compete. As far as the group discussion concern, group discussion is one of the standard selection tools. A group of students is assigned a topic for discussion 10 to 15 minutes. Your academy record and scores enables you to be called for interview, but it never guarantees your selection. If you want to be selected, it depends largely on the performance. And that performance, this being the first task, most of the employer do the same thing. We must remember two things. What are they? It is a knowledge and a skill combination of both that is important. Knowledge itself consists of what? Understanding the topic that has been given to you. I'll give you an example. Sometime we were in a group discussion, and the topic which was given to them was human trafficking. And the whole group, unfortunately, probably they didn't understand the meaning itself. They started discussing how to monitor the traffic in a city road. So that's the problem. So because they didn't understand the problem itself. And then level of understanding of the world around you, then only you can afford it. Otherwise, you cannot afford to discuss anything, isn't it? So that is next comes your, what is it? How do you get the information? That is the content. Knowledge gives the content, isn't it? And content comes through listening, watching, and reading. Listening is a lifelong free education. It may come from uncalled for area. Even a illiterate person, if you listen to him, he got some wisdom to be told to you. Understand? So normally you can expect advice come from unexpected quarter. So you should be prepared to listen to them, understand them. Second way of improving your knowledge and or improve your content is watching and experiencing. Experience firsthand and observe from a sideline. Why? If you are in the part, suppose you are playing a football match, football. And if you are one of the players, you are concentrating more on your own skill and trying to make your team win. You're not concentrating on the whole, that other team, what is the strength, what is the weakness. You're trying to concentrate, you're focused on this limited area. But if you come outside and sit outside like a coach or the mentor who does it on there, he is looking what is so right, what is not so right. And you are looking about a wider field of view. So this increases, when you look at the sideline, it increases your field of view. You can look at the both sides, your strength and your weaknesses, and you would like to exploit your strength. Then normally, when you take a picture, you are trying to zoom in and zoom out. Zoom in to look at the details of the what is happening, and zoom out to get a holistic view. Gestalt talks about, now you must zoom in and zoom out to get the full view. Because if you want to find the resolution, you say you see anything at a distance, you are not in a position to decipher whether it's a human or a tree. But you start concentrating, look at the whole, that is the silhouette, and then try and look at the parts. You are in a position to discern whether it's a human or a tree or an animal or anything. So that is what it comes here, zoom in, zoom out. And normally, what you see, you must believe it. not hearsay. Next, we have must ensure we don't have biases that we call cognitive biases, social biases. We got in-group bias and out-group bias. In-group bias means anyone he is within my group, he's the best person. Anything he's outside my group, he's not so good. That is what we talk about. Okay. And we must keep our radar open 24 hours. I do not know what information is going to come to me when. Best of the idea comes to you when you are in the night sleeping. Best of the problem solved. And next content is reading. If you don't read, you will not get the total information. So this is what is comes into, this is how you can increase your skill level. Okay. Now, what is the skill? That was the content, the knowledge. As far as skill is concerned, we call analytical skill. Management is an applied discipline. You have to use your analytical skill to apply theory to the practical. What you read in the book is theoretical. Unless you apply in your life, you cannot afford to be successful. Now, as far as the examiner is concerned, he is thinking, he wants to find out, is candidate able to think clearly about the situation? Dig into the treasure of knowledge that he has acquired and apply that knowledge it usefully in the short time that he has to make a point. Because you've got only 10 to 15 minutes time. Selection, you are selected or rejected. Now, so students can train themselves to think analytically. How? It is an attitude which one can develop as opposed to not to think at all. You must really ask question why and how. Remember, I have been talking about so many topics when we talk about various topics on SSB, something which is aside. Not everyone knows what SSB is. But why and how, that is what is more important. No one talks about it. And lastly, you should be able to communicate well. So communication skill itself is very important. You may be having the best of the idea. If you are not in a position to communicate your views, probably that you have no use. How do you prepare for the communication? That is the next question. It is not about speaking a lot or speaking in a stylish language or using big words. You must be in a position to convey your views. That is what a simple way you should be able to convey your views. You are not going to impress. You are supposed to communicate. You may be the best in, say, very good in English. But if other person doesn't understand English, what is the point of talking in English? Okay, so you should also be a good listener, because there may be certain points which other person wants to convey to you. And if you don't understand what he's trying to convey, you will not be in a position to give out your views on the subject. Next, you should articulate your points of view in a way that is easy for others to comprehend. We already talked about it.
Organizing ability.
Yeah. And they should talk sense. There's no point talking nonsense. It is not needed like a garbage. You must talk to them. There's no point talking. You keep on talking for half an hour and a point you want to convey is only one. Simple. So good communication is skill. You have to be a good listener, good speaker, and speak at the right time. Use easy to understand English, and you must be in a position to get across your points. But the communication, how do I develop it? You are good, at least Ganga is good, she can talk, that's okay. They may not be good people around there, so you must have the tendency to talk to yourself. Stand in front of me, talk to yourself alone, take a topic, see can you afford to make some sense out of what you're speaking or not. You may even, when you're walking, there's no harm in taking a topic and talking to yourself. Take a topic. That's the way we can afford to prepare for communication skill. Okay. Next comes your, what is the team skill? It is not alone. You cannot change the world alone. You require a team, some people to work for you. It is the group which matters. So if you have to survive in a group, you have got no option but to listen to others. If you don't listen, you cannot afford to be taking the right judgment, making the right judgment. And now, there may be a difference in the group. How do you handle those differences? I call it, you must dissent to assent. So there will be dissenting words would be there, but that doesn't go against you. Normally we take an offense if someone talks against this or some gives a point. You should be able to, are you in a position to get across your point of view or not? Now, there is a thin line of difference between assertiveness and aggressiveness. I expect you to be assertive, but never aggressive. Yeah, you must convey your point of view in a very poignant manner. Even poignant manner, isn't it? Sure. They must understand you mean business, that's all. Now, if you are a good person, good team member, others will automatically try and associate themselves with you. It is not necessary you will succeed every time. There will be failure, there will be stresses will come into play. So how well are you in a position to handle those stresses? That is what is more important. Then decision-making is very important. You cannot wait indefinitely for making decision. Otherwise, you will lose a salient or vital time itself. Okay. So in short, the group discussion panel is testing whether you know the topic well or not. Are you able to present your point of view in logical manner? Are you interested in understanding what others feel about the same subject? Or are you able to conduct yourself with grace in a group situation? So that is what they are all important for as well. This can or what the group discussion concern. So how do you prepare? You must read more. Develop keen interest in current affairs. Seek opportunity discussed among small group of friends that you have got it. Okay. So you must train yourself to a good listener. Develop patience to listen attentively. Acknowledge that everyone has got something to say. Your job is to articulate your point of view in a way that is easy for others to comprehend. If you, whatever you are conveying, if they don't understand, that's of no use. Inculcate the good habit of structuring your thoughts and presenting them logically. What points? That is all coherence. First point should come first. Second point should come second. So depend on the priority and how the things are going, that is more important. Okay. How do you prepare for success? Earlier we used to write essays, and now probably writing essay has been converted to writing a paragraph. I think that's how the new education system is. Well, that's one of the way. Read more, develop keen interest in current affairs, seek opportunity to discuss in the group, learn to respect others' point of view, learn to be open-minded, recognize the fact that people think differently about issues, train your mind in the think analytically. Your group discussion arguments should be have the meat, that is the content. Conduct who work with the group, accommodate diverse viewpoint and assert themselves without aggression, score high. That is what is there. Finally, quick take is here. Train your mind to think analytically. Your group discussion arguments should have meat. Respect other people's view. Listening is important. Practice patience. Writing essay can improve your structure. Okay. This is what, any doubt as far as how do you prepare for group discussion concern? Any doubt?